This report on the uprated Saturn 1, the vehicle which will provide the power for the first manned Apollo flights and Apollo Applications Program missions, covers progress during January, February, and March 1967. At Cape Kennedy, tragedy struck the Apollo-Saturn program when three astronauts, Virgil Grissom, Edward White, and Roger Chaffee, lost their lives in a spacecraft fire while preparing for the AS-204 manned orbital flight. Although the January 27th fire destroyed the spacecraft, shown here being removed for detailed examination, the launch vehicle was undamaged. The review board, appointed immediately after the incident, determined that the fire was probably caused by an electrical arc. The precise origin of the fire will probably never be determined. As a result of the board's investigation, several areas of the spacecraft are being redesigned. To maintain program momentum, NASA is revising mission assignments and flight schedules. Marshall Management is responding to these changes and will provide flight-ready launch vehicles as required to support the new mission plans. Saturn 204 will now launch an unmanned lunar module into Earth orbit for tests and checkout this fall. The changes required to the vehicle and ground support equipment, although extensive for the available time, are well underway and will be completed as scheduled. In conjunction with the new mission, the vehicle is shown being moved in late March from KSC's Launch Complex 34 to Launch Complex 37, which is equipped for lunar module launches. Saturn 204 was selected for the next mission in order to take early advantage of the last fully instrumented R&D vehicle. Saturn 205, 206, and 207 will be launched in that order. Saturn 205, whose stages and instrument unit are now ready and in storage at contractor plants, will now launch the first manned Apollo Command and Service Module into Earth orbit. It will also be the first flight of a Block 2 Apollo spacecraft unit. Saturn 205 was originally slated to launch the Command and Service Module portion of the first Apollo dual launch mission, which had been scheduled for late this year. Therefore, it will require only minimal modification for this new mission. Saturn 206, which was originally slated to launch a lunar module this summer, has been de-erected from LC-37, and its stages and instrument unit will be placed in storage until needed. Saturn 206 will be used next year, together with 207, in a dual launch mission. This mission is scheduled as a backup to Apollo Saturn 503. After replacement of two Rocketdyne H1 engines with defective turbine blades, the first stage for the Saturn 207 vehicle was placed in storage by the prime contractor, the Chrysler Corporation, at the Marshall Space Flight Center's Michoud Assembly Facility at New Orleans. The stage will be removed temporarily from storage next quarter to recheck out the stage with the two new engines in place. Post-static firing checkout of the first stage for the Saturn 208 vehicle is being conducted by Chrysler Michoud. After testing is completed, the booster will be stored until needed. The four engines with defective turbine blades were replaced before checkout started. The Saturn 209 first stage was shipped to the Marshall Center in January, following completion of pre-static checkout at Michoud. At Marshall, the stage underwent a successful short-duration static test conducted by Chrysler personnel, followed by a successful long-duration firing. The stage was then returned to Michoud for post-static checkout, which is due to be completed next quarter. Pre-static checkout of the first stage for Saturn 210 has been finished by Chrysler Michoud. The stage is now being prepared for shipment to Marshall early next quarter for static firing. Final assembly of the first stage for Saturn 211 is in progress at Michoud, with completion scheduled early next quarter. Assembly of the Saturn 212, the final one under the present contract, is underway and is scheduled to be finished during the next report period. The second stage for the Saturn 207 vehicle has been placed in storage at the Douglas Aircraft Company's Sacramento Test Center following acceptance firing last quarter. Some modifications will be accomplished prior to shipment to KSC. Post-firing checkout of the Saturn 208 second stage was completed at SACTO late in the quarter. A successful acceptance firing had been performed in January. The stage was accepted by NASA on March 22nd and will be placed in storage until needed. The Saturn 209 second stage completed factory checkout early in the quarter and was shipped to the Sacramento Test Center. There, the stage is in storage awaiting completion of acceptance firing of a Saturn V stage. This is because stages from both Saturn programs will have to use the remaining test stand at the test center, the other stand being substantially damaged when a Saturn V stage exploded during testing early in the quarter. However, because of quick and thorough action by the board investigating the explosion and positive direction by Marshall and Douglas management, the requirements of both programs will be met. The second stage for the Saturn 210 vehicle was in the final phases of factory checkout at Huntington Beach at the end of the quarter. Fabrication and assembly operations on Saturn 211 and 212 second stages, the last two under the present contract, were continued by Douglas Aircraft throughout the report period. Assembly operations for the second stage of Saturn 211 included installation of aluminum foil inside the stage's liquid hydrogen tank as a fire retardant. The material is being installed in this stage since it is scheduled to be used in the Apollo Applications Program as an orbital workshop. In this role, the stage, after it has achieved orbit, will be used as a laboratory and living quarters for astronauts during long-duration flights. Checkout of the instrument unit for the Saturn 207 vehicle was finished this quarter by IBM at its Huntsville, Alabama facility, and the IU is now in storage until called for. On the Saturn 208 instrument unit, installation of components, such as these thermal conditioning panels or cold plates, was completed during the quarter, and checkout of the unit is underway. Structural fabrication for the Saturn 209 instrument unit has been completed by IBM, and component assembly began in March. Structural fabrication for the 210 IU started in February and is continuing. Structural members are available for the 211 IU, and structural fabrication is scheduled for next quarter. On March 1st, NASA headquarters authorized the Marshall Center to request proposals from the uprated Saturn I prime contractors for purchasing 16 additional vehicles. The primary mission for these vehicles will be Apollo Applications flights. The proposals will be based on the procurement of 4 vehicles immediately, procurement of long lead time items for 3 more vehicles, and an option to complete the 16 vehicle order. In summary, despite the tragic AS-204 accident witnessed by the period January-February-March 1967, NASA moved to maintain the momentum in the program for which astronauts Grissom, White, and Chaffee had given their lives. Marshall made the necessary changes to provide launch vehicle support to the redefined missions without disruption of overall program goals. Assembly, checkout, and ground test operations progressed steadily to provide the boosters, second stages, and instrument units for the vehicles which will achieve the uprated Saturn I missions that lie ahead.